Hello, my name is Clint and I'm your tech prof. Today I thought I would talk about the latest trend in working from home and doing live presentations or teaching live sessions online. Let's be honest, the world is changing. One of the things that I have observed over the last few weeks is that online collaboration tools being used by business professionals and teachers are limited in the balance between privacy and professionalism. In both teaching and presentations, continuity and flow is critical in order to keep the audience engaged and focused on the topics. Today, I'd like to show you a couple of free tools that can drastically improve the quality of your presentations. It needs to be more about the teaching or the presentation than trying to mess with the technology. As you can see on the screen here, I have all the applications I need for my current presentation. And so what I'm going to use is I'm using OBS Studio in order to navigate through my presentation. One of the problems with all of the online collaboration tools that we have available to us, such as Microsoft Teams, Blackboard Collaborate Ultra, and some other collaboration tools, is that we can share our entire screen, but sometimes that's not the best thing to do for privacy sakes and those kind of things. You don't want the teacher's desktop always being shown. So if you're a gamer, you don't want to see you got a game running in the background or something like that. For the most part, we want to share one application at a time. From what I've experienced, all of the collaboration tools, if you want to switch applications that you're sharing, you actually have to stop sharing and then reshare again. And that makes a break in the presentation. And if you have students, they're going to lose focus. They're going to look away for a second or two. They're going to go get a drink. And then when you finally do get the second application up, you've lost them and you have to start over again, and you have to re-engage the students again, or you have to re-engage that business partner again if you're doing a presentation. So what we're going to do is we're going to talk about how do we do a continuous and engaging presentation, whether it be in the classroom or at a business presentation, using OBS Studio. So as you can see, I've got OBS up in here and running, and I've got my camera up here and going. I can turn that on and off if I want, or I can leave it on. I can flip between different applications that I have running, as you can see here. I can go into the browser, I can view through different tabs, I can scroll through, and everything that I'm doing is continuous. I can show in one scene, I can turn things on and off. So if I want to leave my camera in one spot, I can do that. I can go and show multiple applications at the same time. I can show two applications. So if I've got Visual Studio open and I'm coding and I want to see what the coding is doing as a live presentation in the browser at the same time, I can actually present this back and forth, and I can teach and I can do professional development through this process. If I want to show my full webcam, I can show my full webcam. Hi, how are you guys today? And then I can also share my desktops as well. So you can see this is the desktop I'm currently sharing. This is my other desktop, which is a 4K desktop, so a little hard to collaborate with as well. You'll find if you're using a 4K monitor, the collaboration tools don't treat them very well. They downscale, and then it doesn't look very good at all. The first thing we want to do is we want to bring up some simple screen. All right, so here's my simple screen. I'm going to right-click on this screen, and I'm going to enable projector. Now notice that this is a preview projector. So if you're going to use the studio mode, you don't want the preview projector up. What you want to do is you want to go into studio mode, go to the program side of it, and click windowed projector. And now you can see it's created a projector window, which is projecting the output from OBS Studio. I can turn studio mode on and off. That's my choice. But as you can see, this projector window now shows the output. Because this is a separate window, most of the collaboration tools will recognize this as a separate window. So if I go to Microsoft Teams here, and I'm already in a meeting, I've got a meeting already set, I can put this up here, I've already got a meeting set, I can go ahead and share my screen, and in my sharing screen, you see there's a windowed projector application here. If I share that application, now the students or the other people within the meeting can see exactly what's being shown in this projector window. That's fantastic, because now if I want to go back to Teams I can bring Teams back up. I can go ahead and show the conversation or hide the conversation. So if I need the chat window open, I have the chat window. If I want to see who the current participants are, I can do all that, and I can have that in the background. Now, when I need to start my presentation, I can go ahead and choose which scene I want. So I'm going to choose browser, and up comes Chrome. I don't need this preview here anymore because my projector window shows it. So let me reduce my screen real estate there. So I have this screen open. This is the screen of what they're seeing. I don't need to have that up there, but just while you're learning and seeing how this works, it might be good to see it. But as I look through the browser, I can see different things. I can show them what's going on. I can decide, okay, so now it's time to do some database work. So I'm going to bring up SQL Developer, and then I need to bring it up on my desktop. There it is. I can go ahead and type in here, and you can see in the presentation window, they can see what's going on. I can even minimize that window and get ready for the next one. So say I want my browser to be in this screen because I'm talking about SQL Developer. I can prepare the next thing without changing what they're seeing. When I've got it ready, then I can change the appropriate scene. So now I'm showing the right thing. That happens quite often if you're showing something in a browser, and say you're using Blackboard for teaching. You could have something like a user list or a grade book up on the screen, and you want to make sure that that's not what students are going to see. So you don't want to switch to the browser and then have to quickly change away before students see anything, especially if you're recording the presentation for later viewing. That's now permanently in the recording, and students can pause and see what's there. So you always want to make sure what you're displaying on the screen is appropriate for the particular audience. So really, really good way to switch applications back and forth using Microsoft Teams. This will also work in Blackboard Collaborate Ultra. It will work in Big Blue Button. It will work in a lot of different collaboration tools that are out there where you're sharing one screen at a time. I hope this helps. For those of you who are unfamiliar with OBS, I'm going to have another video or another couple videos on how to download OBS, install it, and how to set it up and configure it for professional presentations or teaching online. Thank you for watching.